Guys, to make this beautiful sleeve that you see on the screen, what I'm going to do, I'm going to be doing splash and spread, right? And I have my pattern paper here, and this pattern paper is for my short sleeve, right? So the length I have here is 9 inches, right? So I still need my sleeve to be longer than this length I have here. So what I will do is that I'm going to work with this pattern. So there's no need of drafting another pattern. I'm going to work on this pattern. Then when I'm cutting it, I'm going to extend the length, right? I'm going to extend the length. So what I will do is that I will spread it on another paper because I don't want to place it on my net directly. The reason be that the net is small and I want to manage it as possible as I can. So yeah, I have 5, so I'll slash this part open, after which I will be placing it on another paper to spread it, right? So you can label it. So I'll cut it through. So I'm going to spread it, so I'll just place it this way. So I don't really have a measurement for my spreading, but what I'm doing here is that I'm going to spread it according to the fabric that I have, right? So you can spread it as much as you want. Go ahead, if you have enough fabric, go ahead and spread as much as you want, depending on how the fullness of what you are working with. But I'm just going to spread according to the fabric that I have. So guys, here is the another paper that I want to spread it on, right? So just for a beginner friendly, I'm just want to explain more in detail. So after splashing it the way I've slashed it this way, so this is our number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5. So these are the 5 pieces that we have now, right? So what I did to have, you know, by the time you spread it like this, so you have to follow the curve, right? Our curve at the armhole area, so that by the time you bring it together, that curve will still maintain the curve, and the damp part to the length, so that one will not be longer than one. So how will you achieve that? What you will do is that, you know that this number 1 is the center part, so this part has to be cut folded, right? So what I'm doing here is that I'm also going to follow a guide in the spreading, just for the case of people that will still ask, by what did I spread it with? So I'm going to follow 4 inches. I'm going to be spreading it by 4 inches. So what I did was, I remember the length of the sleeve is 9 inches, so I just measure from this edge here down 9 inches, right? So let's mark that down, and you roll it up this way. I'm going to make sure that is touching this 9 inches, so whatever, even the short one too, has to come down to this 9 inches. In that way, you will maintain your curve at this upper part. So what I do is that I measure this 4 inches this way, then I make sure that this first one is touching the edge here, which I will cut on folded, right? Then I measure 4 inches, then I place the second one. So what I did is I just place it this way, then I use my marker to rule it this way, right? Then put my gum under, then place it on it. I did the same thing to this number 3, measure 4 inches, then I also do the same thing. So let's do it to this number 4. So what I did is I just place it this way, right? After measuring the 4 inches, then place it this way, make sure that it's touching this 9 inches too. Then you use your marker to rule it this way, right? Then you also rule this part too this way. This is just for beginner friendly, so if you are expert in this, you can just do it fast. But for people that don't really understand, beginners, right? So you have your mark this way, then you place your gum on it, right? So this is my paper gum, so I place it on it. This is number 4, so we place the number 4 on the line this way. Make sure that it's touching this line that we have here, so that we can have a perfect shape, right? So this is it now. So we'll do the same thing too to this number 5 too. We measure 4 inches, so this is the 4 inches. Then after which, you can also rule it this way, then you use your gum on it, right? Then you bring it, you place it on it like this, so you can see what I'm doing, right? So you place it on it like this. Now, when I was drafting this sleeve, I've already considered the half inch that we use to sew it on this upper part. So it's just a normal basic sleeve that you draft, right? Then you consider the half inch that you use to join it to your sleeve to it. That is when you are coming down for your cap height, right? So let me not bore you with too much of that. So just follow what I have done here now. Then you trace it out this way. Trace it out this way. Right, so just follow what you have this way. So that's it. So you can see now that you have a curve, right? Because our sleeve normal, it has the armhole area is curvy. So when you follow this, if you follow through on the way I've done it here, you have your curve back. So I said I want to extend the sleeve length, right? So this is stop at 9 inches, and I want it to be at least 18 inches, right? So this pattern paper is now to 18 inches, so I'm going to put this another pattern here again. So let me do that. So here I've already placed another paper here, so I'm just going to place it this way. Then I will measure from this up down, or I can just follow this line that I've already have, which is 9 inches, right? So I'll place my tape through this way, which is the 9 inches. Then I'm going to come down 18 inches. So I'll be cutting it out. So this is our sleeve, right? So by the time you have it in total, you have it very big, right? So you will not pleat it. So I will just pleat it randomly on the armhole area, right? So we pleat it here. We also pleat it here on our band. So let me cut it on my neck. So what I will do is that I will notch the midpoint. The band at the wrist is going to be tie, right? So you have to measure your clients. You have to have the measurement of your clients, what his measurement is on this area. So for me, I'm working with 9.5 inches, right? So because that 9.5 inches, you'll be able to pull it off, right? So if you have 9.5 inches like this, it will be difficult for you to pull it off this way. So the easier way to able to pull it off is to make it a tie. So what I will do is that I'm going to pleat this, so you can open it up since you've already notched the midpoint, which is what I have here, and for the upper parts, what I have here, right? So I'm going to pleat this. I'm going to pleat this randomly this way. I'll pleat it to have my in total of 9.5 inches, right? So I'll pleat it this way, pleat it to have my 9.5 inches. Then I'm going to be needing a long rope, right, of this net as well. So let me do that and come back to show you. So guys, here is the long strip, that's the long rope I'm going to be using to tie it at this area here. So the width of this, so you know it's going to be folded into two like this. I'm going to be sewing it out in the form of band, right? So this is a band, right? So if you fold into two this way, we'll have it as 6 inches, right? So this is 5 inches. If when folding into two this way, I have 5 inches. So this 5 inches now, I'm going to remove 1 inch from here. So I'm going to be left with 4 inches. Right, so that 4 inches is the width of the band, the length of the band, right? 4 inches, but here I have 5 inches. So depend on how you want the length to be, that determine what the major length that you should have here. So here I have 5 inches. By the time I remove 1 inches, I will left with 4 inches, which is what I'm working with. And the width of this is 37 inches, right? 37 inches. So I'm just going to gather this to be 10 inches, right? So that means what I'm using from here this way, you have to measure your client. What I want to use here is 10 inches. So that 10 inches now, what I would, so this is the midpoint here. And this is the midpoint too at the upper part. So here is the midpoint now, right? So you also have to fold this into two this way. You fold it into two this way. Then you also notch the midpoint as well. This one too. Here is the midpoint of these two. So now you place them together this way. So this is the midpoint of your band, and you also notch the midpoint of your this sleeve, right? So you place them this way. So on this sleeve here, I'm going to measure 5 inches towards this area. Remember, we need 10 inches, right? So we measure 5 inches towards this area. We also measure 5 inches towards this area. That's in total of 10 inches. So I'll place my tape rule this way, and I'm going to be marking. So I'll place my tape rule this way, and I'm going to be marking 10 inches, 5 inches towards this area. And I'll also place this to this way, and I'll measure 10 inches. So this is the midpoint of the 10 inches, right? So, and this is the midpoint of our band. So after marking the midpoint, so here is the midpoint. So what I'm going to do now is that I will place this on this way. So my band now, this is the right side of my band, right? So you can see the way I wide it. So this is the width, right, of the 10 inches wide, right? So, and this is the band. So facing up, the right side facing up, then I will get the main clothes this way too, right side too. I will use them right side face each other this way, each other this way. And this is the hem part where we have notched. So this is the midpoint, right? This is the midpoint, and this is where the 5 inches of this side end. This is where the 5 inches of this side end. So you can also, for more clarity, you can also mark it here too. So you can also mark the 10 inches too on the band. So I'll mark 5 inches towards this area, then I'll mark another 5 inches towards this area. So this is the midpoint. So from here to here is 10 inches, and this is the midpoint, and this is the right side facing up. So I'll get this, I'll get my sleeve now, then I'll place it midpoint to midpoint this way, right side face each other this way. So I'll go over to my sewing machine. So on that thing again, then you can bring the edge this way. So you are going to need 1 inch, right? You mark 1 inch this way. So let me just make it 1.5 inches for the seam, right? So I'm going to place it on it this way. So I'll place this 1.5 inches away, right? So place it on it this way. You can see the way I place it. So I'll fold it in this way. So I'm going to sew it starting from here. Then this midpoint, you pin it. You pin the midpoint this way. So that means that all this volume that you have here, you are going to put it on this area here. So this volume here, you are going to pleat it on this part. Then this one too, you are also going to get the edge of this. Then you place it on this 5 inch, where this 5 inch to also end. Now remember, we also measure 1.5 inches in this way. That is for your seam allowance at the side now. So this 1.5 inches is going to be for the seam allowance at the side. So then you also fold it in this way, like this, right? Then you place it on this 5 inches. So what is left here to this part, this volume here, you are going to pleat it, right? Pleat it straight like this on this 5 inches. So I'm going to take it to my sewing machine. What I will do is, as I've mentioned, I'll fold in this 1.5 inches in this way. Then I'll place it on this 5 inches this way, right? Then I will start the pleating like this. You can see the way I'm pleating it. I'll start the pleating like this. I'll start the pleating like this. As I'm pleating, I will be arranging it straight this way. I'll pleat and arrange until I have it all pleated to this part here. Then I'll stitch on it. I'll also do the same thing this way to pleat it like this. Then I'll stitch on it. So I've done it to the second part. So let me just show you what I meant. So this is it after sewing it, after pleating it on it. So this is the band too under, right? This is the band under. So, and this is the sleeve. So what I did is that I measured the 1.5 inches. You can see the way I measure it. Then I fold it in. So you can see the way I fold it in. I fold it in this way. Then I started doing my pleating. Pleat until this is the midpoint, right? Then this one too, the same thing. I fold it in, then I also pleat. So this is how we have pleat it now, right? So you can see the way, the result of what we have now, right? So remember, it is right side face each other. So this is the wrong side and this is the wrong side. So the next thing I'm going, I will bring out the band from under this way. So this is the band. So normal, what you will do is to fold in 1/2 inch inside, then you top stitch on it, right? But you know that this rope side is going to be open, so you have to also sew it this way. So you can either place it like this, then go ahead, then top stitch from this part like this to the other side. But I don't want to top stitch on this side. I want to sew it in. So what I will do is I will fold it in this way. I'll fold it in this way so that I can able to sew this side neatly. So I'll fold it in this way. Then I'm going to start my stitching from here, 1/2 inch. I'll sew it into here, 1/2 inch. And when I now get to where the sleeve, where the pleating starts from, I'll stop there this way. So I'll just back stitch here. So just sew it with 1/2 inch. That the rope side now, sew it with 1/2 inch this way. Then enter the hem part to 1/2 inch. You do the same thing to this other side too. So you are placing them on wrong side this way, so you fold it this way. You can see the way, just follow along the way I fold it. Then you sew it starting from here to 1/2 inch this way, 1/2 inch. Then when you get to where the pleat stop, right, the where the pleat is, then you top stitch there. Then you turn it out. So when you turn it out, then this side too will also go back to this way, right? So then you now fold in this. Then you top stitch on this part, after which you open it up this way. Then you now place the sleeve now. So now I want to sew the sleeve now neatly. Then you now place the sleeve this way. Remember, we've already folded in this. So you open it up this way. Then you are going to sew the side. Remember, the side seam that we'll take in is 1.5 inches. So you start the 1.5 inches from here. Then when you get to this part here, from this the pleat here, you measure 4 inches. Depend on how you want it to open, right? So me, I need mine to be 4 inches. So I'll mark the 4 inches from them. From this 4 inches, I'm going to sew with 1.5 inches to the end. Hope that is clear. So let me do that, then come back to show you guys. After finish sewing it, this is what I have. So I've also sewed it at this part too, right? So and then left the 4 inches that I told you about here, right? So this is the result of what we have now. So this is how it will be tied here, right? So I'm just going to gather it the way, also pleat it, follow the pleating too, pleat it up this way. Then I'll be attaching it to my dress, right? Be gathering it into this, right? So if you want to learn how to make this bustier gown, you can watch my video before this one. I'm going to put the link on the comment section. So I'm just going to gather it on this place, then we'll see the final result. So this is how my own came out. It's so beautiful. I work with the net, the quantity that I have. But if you want yours to be fuller than the one that I made, you can also go ahead and spread it more than the way I spread mine, right? But all the same, it's same beautiful. This is really beautiful, guys. Thank you so much for watching my video. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. And if you want to see how I make this bustier, the damn part, everything, the dress itself, you can watch my video before this one and you will learn how to achieve this. Thank you so much for watching. I will be seeing you in my next one. Please drop your comment. Let me know your thoughts on the comment section. I love you. Bye.